Hi all, welcome. Uncle Mulman here. This is part 12 already about our authority in Christ. Welcome. In half an hour I will do the same teaching in Dutch. So if you are from the Netherlands or from Belgium or whatever, or you speak Dutch, maybe you can watch my other video in 30 minutes. But welcome. Our website is www.cwowi.eu, Church Without Walls International. So this is a teaching about our righteousness in God. And last week I started about in Ephesians 6, about our spiritual weapons. And today I want to talk to you about peace. In Ephesians 6:15, it says, having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. The Amplified says it like this, having shod your feet in preparation to face the enemy with the firm-footed stability. And that's a good way how the Amplified mentioned it, with the firm-footed stability. Because those shoes that Roman soldiers were wearing, they were not normal shoes, but they were a sort of killer shoes. They began near the knee, extended down to the feet, and they were made of metal, and they were made very uncomfortable, of course, for the soldier, but very necessary and essential for the safekeeping of the soldier's legs, because he walked through thorny bushes and so on. And then on the bottom of the shoes, the bottom had sharp, long spikes, and intended to hold him there in place, so when he was in battle, it made him almost immovable. But additional to that, one kick with those shoes, with those spikes, and the enemy would be wounded severely or even be dead. So that is what Paul is saying here. He is connecting the gospel of peace with those killer shoes. That peace of God will hold you in place, will make you immovable to whatever the enemy is doing. So when you go, for instance, to Romans 14:17, this very interesting scripture, and I want to focus a little bit on peace. It may be an interesting subject right now, because we are entering like the holiday season. In 2 weeks it will be Christmas, and Christmas is like peace on earth, you know. So Romans 14 says, for the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking. And that's interesting when you enter like a holiday season like this. But it is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Meaning God's kingdom is righteousness, in right standing, being in right standing with God, being in right standing with your fellow brother and sister. But also God's kingdom is peace, meaning that you have that peace of him in your heart and in your spirit. And also the joy. Joy is something different than happiness. Happiness is depending on your circumstances. You can be happy because something nice is going to happen, because you have your birthday or whatever. But joy can always be there, because joy is of the spirit. So, okay, so the peace. What is the peace when you have that right standing, when you have the peace and the joy? That's because God lives in you. Christ lives in you, the hope of glory. And his presence is always there, and his peace is always there. Even when you are in a situation, when you are, for instance, in a stressful situation, maybe right now you have to plan a lot to have Christmas, preparing stuff. You can be anxious, or maybe you're wondering, do I have enough money to buy the presents? How will everything go? Maybe you have a health issue, maybe there is another need, maybe you need a job, and there can be so many circumstances and difficulties in your life that you feel there is no peace. But when you really center on what is in your spirit, you will find that his presence is always there, and his peace is always there, because he will never leave you. And that's so wonderful. Psalm 23 says that he walks with us through the valley of death. You know, we oftentimes like to be transported out of that valley, out of that dark place, out of that hard place, that difficult situation. But he is walking with us through it, meaning he is there. His presence is there, and his peace is there. And that is wonderful. And when you look back in your life, for instance, what I always do when I face a situation and I don't know what to do, I think, oh, your mind can go crazy and you can have all kind of thoughts. How will this happen? What's going to be? I always go back to how the Lord provided for me and for us in the past. And what I do, I always write things down in a sort of, a diary. You know, things that I'm going through, the words the Lord gave, and then later on, of course, when he came through, because he does come through, he's always faithful in doing that. And go in your mind, go back to those times that you had, and then you will see that his presence was still there. and he made provision for you, and there was healing, and there was an answer, and there was a job when you needed a job. But he will go with you, through those circumstances. So that is actually wonderful to know. What does it mean, that peace mean? That peace means that the Father has your situation under control. That whatever you are facing, you are going through, he knows. And he has it under control, and he is saying, all will be well. That is what that peace in your spirit is communicating. What you have to do, you have to guard your heart, you have to guard your thought life, because your heart, your thought life, your emotions can be against that peace. But that peace must be the controlling factor, meaning whatever he is communicating, that is the truth, because God is true, he cannot lie, and the Holy Spirit lives in you, and he is the spirit of truth. So whatever he is communicating to you, that is the truth. So do you have peace in your situation? That means that the Father will come through, and he has an answer, and he has made provision. How often did the Lord in the gospel say to the disciples or to others, peace be with you? You know, we as human beings, so oftentimes we get so afraid or whatever, we don't know what to think or what to do, but he's always saying, peace be to you. He is there, you are his child, everything will be okay. In John 16, 33, Jesus says, in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, take courage. I have overcome the world. What does that mean? In the world you will have tribulations. When you look up that word in the Greek, it means pressure, stress, adversity, anguish, and it is used of crushing grapes or crushing olives in the press. You know, when you are crushing grapes, you know, and you push them and push them and push them still till the juice comes out of it. And sometimes you might feel like everything, your life is going out of you, you know. There's nothing, you are drained, you are exhausted, you are tired, and you feel that pressure. But the Lord said, in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation. It's something that's just going to happen. We are not free from tribulation, from those pressure times. But in me you can have peace. And Isaiah 9:6 says that Jesus, he is the Prince of Peace. Ephesians 2:14 says, he himself is our peace. Philippians 4, a wonderful scripture, says, the peace of God which surpasses or rises above all understanding, that peace will guard your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. So the peace of God, I'll mention it again, which passes all understanding, meaning it goes above your thinking. You cannot comprehend it. You know there is peace in your spirit, but your mind is going like this, and you don't know what to do or where to go, and what will be the solution, but you do have that peace. It surpasses all understanding, and that peace will guard your heart and mind. What does that mean? That word guard is actually a military term. It pictures a guard or a sentry standing guard as a protection against the enemy. So it's like a bridge, you know, or like a castle which had a bridge. And when there is that bridge is up, it means nothing can come in. Or when the guard is there, he is protecting you and saying no enemy or no wrong things will come in. That peace is like that guard. So when you have that peace, you have to say no, I do not allow those thoughts, I do not allow those emotions to rule me and to dominate me, but that peace will dominate my heart and that peace will dominate my thoughts, meaning everything is under control. So God's peace is like a guard, and it will guard your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. And I pray that this will happen for you during this holiday season, that you will sense that peace in you, meaning everything is under control, the Father has it under control, no matter what you are facing right now, no matter how difficult things can be, if you need a job, if you need healing, whatever, if that peace is there, the Father has it under control, and he will walk with you through it. But let that peace dominate. Do not allow those thoughts and those anxious thoughts and emotions to rise up, but let that peace which is in your spirit rise up, go to your mind, and from there it will give you peace in your body. Last scripture in 2 Peter, 1st chapter, verse 2, it says, grace and peace be multiplied to you. And that is my prayer for you, that grace and peace may be multiplied to you. Bless you. See you next time.